guys, welcome back to my channel. So the last week I had asked you guys on my Instagram Q&A that what more of recipes would you like to see on the blog, and so many of you said more of baking recipes. So I wanted to share with you this really easy and minimalistic lemon sponge cake that I keep making all the time, and because it's the onset of summers, it's also very refreshing, and it just has a handful of ingredients. And we will also make a lemon sauce drizzle for it, which is also absolutely spectacular and super easy. So let's get started. So the secret to a very good sponge cake is butter. Now there are two things that you need to keep in mind when you use butter in a sponge cake. First of all, it should be at room temperature. So this is a knob of butter and this has been sitting at room temperature for the past 2 hours. So now it's soft, it's not melting, it's not cold, but it's just at the right temperature where it will be very easy for me to beat it. And the second most important thing, so the butter has to be beaten till it becomes really smooth in texture and it acquires a pale color. So that's when you know that your sponge cake is going to be absolutely delicious. So let's start with the butter. This is 200 grams butter. At room temperature, very important. So it's been about 5 minutes, and if you can see, the butter has acquired a beautiful pale creamish color, and this is what we need for the sponge cake. Now to this softened butter, I'm going to add 150 grams of sugar. I'm using brown sugar here, which is granulated. If you don't have brown sugar, just use granulated white sugar, that should be fine. And make sure you beat this till it acquires a creamy texture. This cake comes together in one bowl, so I'm going to add 200 grams of flour, and I'm going to break open 4 eggs into this. Make sure your eggs are at room temperature and make sure that they are also fresh. Half a teaspoon of vanilla. I'm going to put the zest of 1 lime. Just scrape from the edges. The juice of 2 limes is what's going to go in into the batter, and I will give it one mix with my spatula. And the last ingredient that I'm going to add is, that's 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Just going to mix it with my spatula so that it's... Now the reason why I added the lemon in the end is because when you mix lemon with a dairy product, it just splits. So it's very important that you add it in the end after you've added the sugar and the flour, so that it does not mess up the batter. And the baking soda also I didn't add in the beginning because beating baking soda too much makes the cake too dense. So this is perfect. Now I will just stop. It smells beautiful and citrusy. So now I'm just going to transfer it to my baking tray. So I'm going to be using this rectangular baking tray. So I'll just pour the batter here. Make sure you line the baking tray with parchment paper like this so that the cake is easier to take out once done. Now this is going to go into the oven and I'm going to bake it for 30 to 40 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. And everybody's oven is a little bit different, so make sure that you bake it enough. So what will happen is that the top layer will become golden brown and the cake will start coming off from the edges of the parchment paper. So that's when you know that it's done. So let's put this in the oven and I just can't wait. So now while our cake is baking, we are going to prepare a delicious and super easy lemon drizzle to pour it on the top and just enjoy it. It just requires two ingredients, lemon juice and icing sugar, and that's it. For the simple lemon drizzle, I am going to take out the juice. So here I have the juice of about 7 limes and 1/4 cup of icing sugar, or granulated sugar will also work. So I'll keep adding sugar to this as long as I want, because the consistency has to be of a thick liquid. So I'm going to mix it up. So another 1/4 cup goes in. So as you can see, it has acquired a certain color and it's become thick, but I want it a little more thick, so I'm going to add my last 1/4 cup of icing sugar and give it a last mix. So I've been mixing for the last 5 minutes and you can see how much of a difference has come. Make sure there are no lumps in your icing sugar. It's beautiful, it's citrusy, it's lemony, and it's sweet at the same time. So I just want to give it a quick taste and see if this is good. Just quickly taste it. Yum! It is so good. Now the best part about this sauce is that you can store it in a glass jar and you can add it whenever you want to, and you don't need a lot of it in your cake. So for every slice that you want to eat, just pour like a teaspoon over it. It's just more than enough. This two ingredient lemon sauce drizzle is heavenly. So as you can see, it's soft and moist. So, and it has also come off from the edges. There's a beautiful crust on top and it's beautifully cooked through. So let this cake cool down and come at room temperature and then we will cut up a slice. Okay. Wow, that crusty top is just amazing. Let's see how it looks from the inside. Oh my god. Just look at how fluffy that is. And it's buttery and smells so good. So I'll just cut all the pieces now. Just going to put one piece here. Put that lemon drizzle on top. A teaspoon and a half. And add a splash of green. I'm going to put like a mint leaf over here. It's time to taste. I have put enough lemon drizzle on top of the cake, so let's just try it. Wow. Oh my god, that is delicious. That crust is delicious. It's crunchy, but the cake is just the opposite. It's soft, it's moist, the lemon flavor is shining through, but that drizzle on top is really, really the hero here. I know it was the simplest thing to make, but the difference that it creates is unbelievable. So please try this recipe at home. I promise you will love it. It is very, very easy. Anybody can bake it. It all comes together in one bowl, as you saw. So I hope you try this recipe. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. And I will be coming up with another recipe very soon. Stay safe, take care, and keep smiling.